This video presents an overview of the new Canvas analytics from an actual class. This was a full semester, three-unit class in U.S. history. The new analytics link is available in the course navigation. On this page, there are four tabs: course grade, weekly, online activity, students, and reports. The course grade tab shows all of the assignments listed in the course, sorted by due date. Hover the mouse pointer over an assignment to get the name of the assignments, and then select the dot to get more information about that assignment in its context card. On the course grade tab, as well as from the context card, the message students who is very similar to the message students who function from the gradebook. For example, the chapter check assignments in this class are quizzes that are open book, no time limit, no late penalty, and unlimited attempts. So it shouldn't be too hard for students to earn a perfect score on the assignments. In case some students miss that information, what I could do is open up the context card for one of these assignments, select the message students who button, choose that it's the range of 0 to 99%, so the three students in this class who did not get 100%. So I can send these students a message saying, don't forget, you can take this quiz as many times as you like. It's an open book quiz and there's no late penalty. On the weekly online activity tab, each line on the chart represents a week. The date is the Saturday at the beginning of the week. And you can hover the mouse pointer over a week dot to get the page views as well as average page views or participations for that week. If you select a dot, you get more information about that week in the context card that pops up. This shows for each student's their counts of page views and participations that week. It also has the information for the whole class. From the weekly online activity tab, if you select the message students who, you get additional options to message students who either viewed, didn't view, participated, or didn't participate. You can also select a particular resource. I'll give you an example. Because it's a history class, primary sources are very important. And so I can select this resource. It's a content page called How to Find and Identify Primary Sources. And I can select the Didn't View tab to identify, in this example, the four students who did not view that particular content page, and then I can send a message to them. You can also select this for a particular week. So if I go back to the entire semester, and I can select a week late in the semester, select the dot for that week, and I can select any of the numbers at the top of the page to pull up the message students who. Again, this is limited to this particular week. So in this example, I might select one of the chapter links from early in the class. My example here is chapter 3. During that finals week of the semester, take a look at who viewed. In this example, I had one student who viewed that early chapter link very late in the semester. Back on the main view for the whole course, this is whether we're looking at course grade or weekly online activity. One of the options we have, if I select the Atkins menu, is to show the data table. So that's the numbers and dates for each of the items. But I can also change the option to show display shapes. This is particularly helpful because what you can do for either the course grade or the weekly online activity is you can select a particular student and even add more than one student. And for each assignment, in this case, you can see how that one student's score compared to the class average. If you select the weekly online activity tab, it's the same thing. You can see how that one student, or in this case, I've got two different students, how their activity compared to the class average. Because I chose the display shapes option on the chart options menu, each of the items in the selection box has a different shape. The students tab shows a list of all the students. In this case, I have those two students selected. If I remove those two students, I can see all the students in my class. I can select an individual student and see that individual student's analytics. And then the reports tab, it gives me a list of reports that I can run at any time to generate a CSV file for downloading and further analysis. If I want more information about what the report includes, I can select the information icon for that report.